making these group cat paintings that take months to years to actually finish. The theme for this painting is all of the cats are blepping or sticking their tongue out in some sort of funny way. I wanted to show you my materials that I use and kind of the space that I'm using right now. It's crucial for me to have a setup that's easy for me to sit down and just start painting. I have a separate room that I paint in right now, and before this, I just had a little corner in my bedroom where I had set up to paint. For this painting, I'm painting on a surface called playboard.
Here I'm showing one that is brand new out of the package.
I have experimented with different surfaces. I hate the texture of canvas. I hate that it shows texture
very clearly throughout the surface.
And it kind of distracts from the details of the painting itself. I like working on paper because it's super smooth and you can focus on the details. But paper is also
very difficult to properly display it and store it. The clayboard that I'm using is a cradled panel, so it's easy to hang. Clayboard also comes in these little tiles and also regular panel with no cradle. I always prep my surface with a couple layers of white gesso. Gesso gives the surface a little bit more tooth so that it's easy to draw on it. Here's a look at all the supplies that I use for the drawing aspect of my paintings. There is willow charcoal, charcoal pencils, X-Acto knife with refill blades, sandpaper, and a couple different erasers. For the actual painting part, I use golden acrylics, Liquitex matte medium, Liquitex gesso, golden retarder, which extends the dry time, and Liquitex Basics acrylic primary red, which I use for the underpainting. I use about three different brushes, a paint scraper, and a metal palette knife, as well as a mason jar to hold my paint water, and a little spray bottle of water as well. There's a lot of prep work that I do before I start painting, including sharpening all my pencils, and mixing up on my paints, as well as the research of what photos I'll use for reference. Here you can kind of see I'm adding that little bit of retarder to my acrylic paints and mixing it in. It extends the dry time for the acrylic paints, which dry super fast, and it also makes the paint a little bit thinner because this brand of paint is thicker than the cheaper ones. And this is just kind of how I mix my paint to start off my palette. Here I'm finally sitting down and deciding on what cat to paint in next. I'm looking through my saved photos that I've saved from submissions and internet famous cats. I decide on this cat based on the color, the shape, and the expression that I think would best suit that particular spot of the painting. Here I'm going in with my charcoal pencils after using willow charcoal to first initially sketch. I'm trying to carefully look at the reference photo and get the proportions right of the face. And then I use matte medium to seal the drawing so that it doesn't mix with the paint colors. After I let that layer dry, I'm going in with my underpainting, which is the Liquitex Basics primary red mixed with matte medium. Those two mixed together create a transparent layer of color so that I'm still able to see the drawing underneath. And then I go in with the basic colors of that cat, just filling in the shapes that I see. The white, the black, the eye color, the tongue color, the nose color. And then slowly blending in all these different mid colors that I'm seeing that creates that 3D image of a cat. When I paint, I'm painting in transparent layers of color by mixing my acrylic paint with a little bit of matte medium. This makes it so that bright pink underpainting still shows through a little bit throughout the painting. I often only paint for about an hour or two before I get up and stretch and take a break. So each cat takes about 3 to 4 sessions of painting to finish, which is about 4 to 6 hours to finish one cat. This is Mau Mau the cartoon cat, and this was the reference photo. You can go follow them on Instagram to see more. For this next one, I decided to do Hank, who had recently passed. He was beloved by many online. He was like a little soggy guy. And he also had no teeth, so he blepped a lot. They called it his little bit of ham sticking out. There's his reference photo. You can still go back and look at all his videos on TikTok and Instagram. Out of the 14,000 email submissions I've gotten, I've probably saved around 1,000 photos so far. And I choose from these photos which cat I'm going to paint next. I choose in the moment which cat I'm going to paint and really just try to feel it out with the painting itself, which one would work best for that spot. I have chosen this white cat that has a particularly angry expression on their face, and they were submitted by a fan. If you would also like to throw in your cats for consideration, you can submit photos to my email for free for a chance to be painted, and just read the submission guidelines on my website before you send them in. This is Sushi, and here is her reference photo submitted by Amina. For this next spot, I decided on this cat named Midas. He was born with 4 ears. Ever since I came across him on Instagram, I think, I wanted to paint him. And he's always blepping through. I think he's got a little overbite. So he's just perfect for this theme. palette that I'm using is two pieces of glass duct taped together with gesso painted on the inside part. It's easy to scrape off old dried paint and then reset my palette with new paint. And I'm using just the basic colors to start my palette. I use Mars Black, Titanium White, Cadmium Red Medium Hue, Cadmium Yellow Medium Hue, and Cobalt Blue Hue. And you can pretty much mix any color from these five. I also never use straight black. I go ahead and right away mix a little bit of yellow and black and a little bit of red and black into two piles. And that's what I use for my darkest darks. Here he is, little Midas. This is his reference photo. And you can check out his Instagram for more photos and videos of him. I'm really particular about how each cat is in each space, like if they're gonna be blocked by a certain way because of their head shape or the way they're turned or faced in the photo. So I really try to make it work for the spot and not focus on which cat it will be, because there's always going to be more chances later on if I really want to paint that particular cat. I just wait until the right moment. But I did settle on this cat named Goblin, and I have been following them for a while, and I really love seeing pictures and videos of Goblin, of her being very silly. Probably my most asked question is, why do I paint the cats pink before actually painting them? Using an underpainting helps you find the lightest and darkest tones of your subject easier than if you were to paint on a white canvas. So take example this cat. It has white fur. It's not easy to paint white fur on a white surface. Another reason I use an underpainting is because it adds depth to the subject. Since I'm painting cats in a more realistic way, I want to add that depth. It can also be used to unify your whole painting together because little bits of the underpainting will show throughout, depending on how much you let show through. You can use any color for an underpainting, but I specifically choose to use bright pink in most of my paintings because it makes the subject more vibrant and lively. And choosing to use it for most of my paintings kind of ties all of my work together with the same mood. There she is, Goblin. And here's her reference photo, submitted by Goblin's mom. Goblin's on a few different social media platforms where you can see all the photos and videos of her on Instagram and Twitter, X, and also TikTok. This next cat, I was really debating on which cat I wanted to do. I knew I wanted to do a black cat, because the rest of the surrounding cats were all light colored, and I really want each cat to shine and not blend into each other too much. So for that spot, I was pretty set on picking a black cat. But sometimes if I'm feeling really stuck on a spot, I'll just move on to a different spot and see if the work flows more easily. I settled on this Maine Coon cat. It's my first time ever drawing or painting a Maine Coon, and I feel like I learned a lot from it. Here I'm starting with the willow charcoal. It's super easy to erase, so that's why I like to start my sketches off with it. It's not as permanent as my charcoal pencil. It's a good way to lay the groundwork for a portrait like this. I use General's charcoal pencils for my main drawing that I'm going to keep and try to draw it as accurately as possible from the reference photo. Drawing finished, I used my kneaded eraser to take away some of that charcoal just so it doesn't smudge as much when I go in and use matte medium to seal the whole drawing so it doesn't mix with the paints. Thank you. this cat's name is Zając.
It is the Polish word for hare and or rabbit.
There's his reference photo, and he was submitted by Gosha, and here's their lovely message that they wrote to me.
Thank you so much for submitting him, Gosha.
And now I feel finally ready to tackle that other spot. I had decided on this cat named Zymes. I've seen him on the internet a few years back. They've been posting for a long while, and his photo seems to be spread around a lot. His tongue hangs out, like, all the time, and it's so cute. And I just knew that he would be perfect for this painting.
I was so happy to finally find the perfect spot to put him. For my underpainting, I mix acrylic paint and matte medium together to create that transparent layer of color. What my palette looks like when it's used, and I'm about to reset it. Zymes all done, and there's his reference photo. You can check out more of his photos and videos on Instagram and Facebook. This is one of my cats named Squid. He just hanging out here. And this is his brother, Haku. They're both only 2 years old. They'll be three next year. This next cat that I'm painting is a Cornish Rex named Ava. I had wanted to paint her in the last painting that I was making, the chorus, but I never got the chance to, so I'm happy I get to paint her in this one. Ava Mom had submitted her blep photo to my email, so that was super helpful. Thank you.
Ava all done. And here's her reference photo. Thank you so much to Ava's mom for submitting her photo. You can see more of Ava on Instagram and TikTok. This is one of my other cats, Atlas. He's super chatty.
You what? Hi, baby. What'd you get yourself into, Haku? Good job, Atlas. You've been so calm about this.
So, for this next spot in the painting, I really struggled trying to decide which cat should be there. This cat that I'm trying to draw here is named Mr. Wiggles, and he was submitted by a fan. And I really did try, but I didn't feel like it was the right cat for that spot. And if my heart isn't in it, then truly, I can't force it, you know? So, I painted over him. I tried sketching out a few different cats here until I finally found the cat that I thought best fit.
Thank you.
This is Lil Bub, otherwise known as Lillian Bubbles. This is the reference photo for this painting. I've actually painted her 3 times now, so it's nice to be able to compare all of them. This is the first time I painted her in 2020. She was in my Raining Cats painting, which is kind of what started all the group cat paintings. And then I painted her again in The Chorus, which I started in 2021 and I finished it in 2022. And finally, we're here at the third time I'm painting her. In my new painting, The Sillies, which I started in 2022, and I'm still working on it currently. Lil Bub is a legend among internet cats, and if you would like to see more photos and videos of her, you should check out their Instagram, their Facebook, their Twitter, and of course their YouTube channel. This next cat was requested by so many people in my comment section, and though his life was very short, he had such a great impact on the cat community. He's a little kitten named Tater Tot, and he had to wear these little casts on his legs, which were affectionately called bonkers. I tried to make him true to size because he's so tiny. The actual painting, he's only about the size of a quarter. The sketch of him's looking a little rough, but it's really just a trust the process. Here he is, all done. And here's the reference photo I used. You can still see all the videos of Tater Tot through the Rescue's Instagram and on their TikTok. And then Ash was his foster mom. She also has an Instagram. Couldn't decide on the cat to be in the spot next to this, so I chose to work on this spot instead. I chose a cat from the submissions. His name is Timmy. Thank you. he is all finished. And here's his reference photo. Thank you to Kat for submitting Timmy.
This is the 8th cat that I've tried to sketch in this one spot, and I finally settled on this one. Little one-eyed cat named Every. All finished, and this was the reference photo sent in. You can see more of Every on his Instagram. In striking contrast with the previous spot, sometimes I just know which cat I want to paint in a particular area, and this one is Little Wisp. Thank you.
here she is, her portrait all done, in the reference photo that I used. You can see more of Wisp on the Rags to Riches Rescue Instagram, TikTok, and Facebook. Thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed. And if you learned something, please consider subscribing, because all I post is cats and cat paintings. At the time that I'm finally finishing this video, I have already started working on the fourth row of cats, but I took a long break to adjust to my new space with my cats, and I should be returning to this painting immediately.
It's pretty easy to get out. Oh my god, he's running. He's excited. He knows it's around the corner. Goodness. Is it dinner time already?